Chalemu of us have is that the compare ourselves, you know, with our contemporaries, with our peers. Some of our contemporaries have gone far ahead of us. But the point is, if you can just think, sit down and look back, you will see some of your contemporaries that are far behind. And you also see some that are actually in the grave. One thing we need to understand is the fact that life is not about speed, but about focus. It's not about who got there first. If you keep looking at where you want to go to, you definitely get there. So I believe focus is more important than speed in life. And that is one thing you need to that's one thing you need to understand and focus on. However, you need the quality of patience. And that is really, really scarce in our dispensation. I've learned some things this past week, you know, listening or flipping through my phone, listening to some messages on YouTube channel. I discovered that what we actually lack is patience. I want something from God. I want it to happen the next day. I don't want to go through the process. And what we fail to understand is that when you face challenges in your next phase of life, it's the process you have learned that will keep you there. When you don't go through the process, instant job satisfaction, instant marriage, what we do? We want things at our fingertips, marriage at our fingertips, food at our fingertips, job at our fingertips. In fact, a lot of us want to have, you know, a four-year program within 3 months, and that's why we want to compress everything just to be able to beat time and cut up the process. And it's a lie. God will not, you know, change his mind or change his process because of the way you are feeling or because of how anxious you are to be able to attain that which he wants to give to you. And we've been lied to several times. You know, what we hear is just say it, you have it, name it and claim it, and that is syndrome. But the point is that God, there's nothing you do in life to untwist God to be able to you know, to talk God into giving you that which you want within a particular time frame, when God actually has a time frame for you or making you learn the process that will actually make you stand for the next phase of life. If a mother has to take injection for a child, a mother will do that. But the point is that the child that is sick will need to take the injection himself, and that is one thing. And so that's why they see the father or the mother will hold the child and let the doctor inject that child, because that's what will make the child better, you know, to be able to live. And that's one thing God is trying to do for us. So until we learn and know this is what God is trying to do, we will remain at that particular level for a very long time. Challenges come, and that is what, that by the time challenges come, you will not be able to withstand the challenge. That is why God will spend his time to train you and make sure you learn the process before he releases that blessing to you. So you must understand that when God asks you to wait, he wants you to learn the process. So don't look at your colleagues. What puts pressure on you most is because you compare yourself with your contemporaries, you compare yourself with your neighbors, you compare yourself with those that have gone ahead of you. Ecclesiastes 9:11 says, I have seen something else under the sun. He said, I have seen something else under the sun. The race is not to the swift or the battle to the strong, nor does food come to the wise or wealth to the brilliant or favor to the learned, but time and chance happened to them all. You need to wait for your timing. By the time God launches you out, you will smile, because by the time the devil, the environment, you know, the time that we are, begins to throw, you know, the fiery darts even into your heart to destroy your faith, you will stand just like Abraham. Bible says Abraham staggered not in unbelief. Why? Because Abraham learned the process. Abraham went through, God had said to Abraham, leave. At that particular time, Abraham was learning, and Abraham followed God until God brought Abraham out and launched him out. And that's why God can call Abraham father of faith. There are two ways to reach God, two ways to fulfill the will of God. The first one is when you hear an audible voice, you are so sure that this is God speaking to me. The other way, and that alone doesn't come every time. It's not every time you hear this is your wife. It's not every time you hear go and work in this office. It's not every time you hear I'm going to give you $1 million. It's not every time you hear move to this location. But there's But there's always a way that can lead to God. Faith will always lead to God. If you look at Hebrews 11, the Bible says, by faith, Abraham moved out by faith. God was not specific about where he was taking Abraham to. Listen to me, young woman. God was not specific where he told Abraham. He said, leave and go to a land where I will show thee. Some of us want specifics. You want God to tell you this is what you must do. You want 100% specific. But the point is that when you listen to the prompting, the push of God telling you this is what you should do, or you are believing this is what God is asking you to do, when you get there, the moment you start, that begins to open other doors to you. Mother Shumalo said something. He said, you only need one door in a house. Because when you enter that house, there are so many other doors. So one door can open other doors to you. Now what you need to do is to believe that God is leading you out. So when you believe God is leading you out, then you'll be focused on where you believe God is leading you to. Once you can obey, that obedience will open up other breakthroughs to you. God will not tell you the details of everything he wants you to do. But when you believe him the first time, then he will open your eyes to be able to see other things. Believe God today. Take your eyes off contemporary. Take your eyes off people that have gone ahead of you. Focus on where God is taking you to. And in a few time, you are going to kneel down and say, praise the Lord. Thank God I waited for God. God bless you real good. I wonder if God got a plan for everyone. I wonder if I could take a second run.